for now in our backyard. So this would be a mini setup, but eventually once this becomes successful and I get the hang of it, I'm planning to turn it into a business. Okay. So probably what I will do is I will rent a land and then build a complete big RAS setup. So right now what I'm trying to do is just a pilot pond or a training ground, so I would learn things and then eventually scale it up. So right now our backyard is I already made a RAS setup. I already designed it based on my research and YouTube videos. Probably you could take a look at that on the last part of our training. So it's 20 square meters. That's the 20 cubic meter is the size of the tank.
Okay.
And I wanted to focus on Vaname shrimp because it's high value and it's in demand here in our country.
Right. And it is a good major player for Bioflock and RAS also.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. So now requirement has been cleared. So first we will go through from the basic, from the water parameter. What parameter you are required to monitor, how to maintain, and what is the ideal value and what is the suggested value for your culture. In the next session, I will go through with the complete RAS setup from planning to installation part, so that you can understand which machinery and which setup is required to full functioning your RAS. Because in the RAS setup, we have a 9 machine and 9 components, like a drum filter, you can also call a mechanical filter, Bioflock filter, UV filter, ozone filtration, carbon dioxide remover, so lots of protein skimmer. So I will complete one by one so that you can understand all the things and take the right decision before investing in the RAS, because RAS is a proven technology, but in term of the management and in term of the operational, this is a very intensive culture in term of the cost. So we will control our input cost so that we will book the profit in 90 to 120 days culture.
Understood.
Perfect. So first we will understand the basic water parameter which is required for the Vaname, which is required for any aquatic animals.
But before you start, Prashant, would it be all right if you give me a little background about yourself, just so I know where you're coming from?
Yeah, perfect. So because you have find out over the YouTube, so we will start from there. So in that agribusiness, not in the aquaculture, we are in the agribusiness from 2008, year 2010, and we have done lots of venture in term of the poultry, in term of the piggery, in term of the rabbit. Lots of venture I have evaluated and successfully pass out to the our client. After that, we have analyzed aquaculture is a vast and lots of opportunity in that business all over the India and all over the world. But lots of awareness is required in term of the successful, because new youth entrepreneur and farmer easily start the venture, but after completion 4 months, 6 months, they face lots of financial challenges. They have sold the crop, they have invested lots of amount, but after analyzing, they have, yes, this is a profitable business, but they are not able to book the profit. After that, we have taken an initiative to spread the awareness as a free awareness, so that whenever everyone want to start the journey in the aquaculture or any agribusiness, before starting, before investing, they want to understand, yes, it is a profitable business, but lots of hard work and lots of knowledge is required for run this successful venture. So from 2018, we have converted our business to as a consultancy. So we are providing all the training session in Hindi and English. I have lots of customer in India also and outside India, like Malaysia, Singapore, Kuwait, Iran, Nepal, Bangladesh, Singapore, lots of cities like Tunisia, some of the major potential
clients. How about from the Philippines? Do you have any clients from here?
Yes, one of the my Indian clients is there, and right now it is building the setup in the with the help of Bioflock, not in RAS.
Okay, nice.
So lots of my client, approx 60-70% going for the Bioflock, because they don't want to invest so much money in term of the RAS, because RAS is a proven technology, but yes, it wants more money before starting. So I have put all the information before hiding any facts and figure. We are providing the DPR, detailed project report, in term of the freshwater species. If you want to do the carp culture, so you can put the details here. If you are doing the catfish farming, so you can get the detail. If you are doing the crab farming, so you can also want that information. If you want to do bioflock or RAS, you get the detail. If you want to the culture for the shrimp, you can also that. So we are not limiting the technology in term of the pond culture, in term of the cemented tank culture, in term of the bioflock, in term of the, because fish and any aquatic animals wants ideal water parameter. They don't want any technology. They want ideal parameter, ideal feed, so they can get a good growth and we will book some profit. So this is our entire journey. Till now we have published around 400 videos, and till now we did not hire any commercial agency to publish our video. We are taking that video from our farm, from our associated client, and without any addition, without any editing, we are simply publish that session. Some paid sessions, some are free awareness session, so that before enter into venture, you have hands-on experience, so that you can write up one more success story in the aquaculture. So this is a short intro from my end. If you want to ask something else, so you can raise.
Okay, thank you for explaining.
So we will start from the scratch. And if you have some time, so you can also refer this video. It is for the shrimp farming. Yes, language is Hindi, but all the components and all the type matter is in English. You can easily correlate what is the expenditure to produce 1 kg shrimp and how much you will get at your farm. So yes, this is a profitable business. Around 50-60% you will get the profit if you will follow the right practice and right guideline. So today is our first session, so we will start from the water quality and water quality management, because it is a primary skill set. You have all the water values on your tip for your success in aquaculture. In the next session, we will go through from the RAS for the shrimp habit and habitat, and how to manage, and how in the next session we will complete our planning, our implementation, and water preparation. and all the feeding habits and day-to-day management techniques. Perfect. So shall we start?
Yep.
Perfect. So we are Ancient India Agribusiness, low investment business ideas and secure your investment. We are working as a progressive farmer, training and knowledge partner, consultant and business planner and partner. So we have started lots of series in the aquaculture related to fish farming, related to carp culture, related to catfish culture, crab farming, lots of free stuff also available on our channel. Before paying, you get lots of knowledge in the aquaculture. Yes, this is a profitable business and you will get a shortest crop for the Vanami shrimp, 90 to 120 days, you will get a saleable product in your market. And definitely your domestic market and your global market both have a potential for the Vanami shrimp. So before starting your aquaculture business, first understand the water chemistry, because you are doing the high intensive culture. Because if you are doing the pond based farming, in the 1 cubic meter you get only 1 kg, 2 kg or 5 kg production. If you are going for the bioflow culture, you will get 3 kg, 4 kg, 7 kg and 8 kg culture. If you are doing the culture in the res, so around 1 cubic meter you can easily harvest 25 kg to 45 kg end product.
So, that's for Vanami up to 45 kilograms?
Yes, or? Yes.
Oh, that's a lot.
That's a lot. So once you will do the overstocking, definitely your efforts will be more. So understand the water chemistry so that you can take care your environment perfectly without losing your money. First thing is the temperature, because aquaculture organisms are cold-blooded animals. They can modify their body temperature to the environment in normal condition, unlike the warm-blooded animals which can react to maintain the optimum body temperature. Optimum range of the water temperature is 22 degrees centigrade to 35 degrees centigrade. In your area, you have not very much fluctuation in term of the temperature. Whenever we are talking about the temperature, we are talking about the water temperature, not the atmospheric temperature. Because whenever you will count and you will just monitor the water temperature, it is always lower from the atmospheric temperature from 5 to 7 degrees centigrade. So whenever we will talk about the temperature, it is a water temperature. So your ideal range is 28 degrees centigrade, but from 22 degrees centigrade to 35 degrees centigrade, your aquatic animal will survive. Because it is a cold-blooded animal, as per the human, they don't have any organism to control the body temperature. They will acclimatize from the tank water if it is the optimum range. So they will get a good survival, they will get a good growth, and they will consume feed so that they will convert in the animal protein. Perfect?
Yep.
Second is salinity. And what is the source of your water?
Right now, since it's in our backyard, it will be tap water.
Tap water, okay. So it is like as a fresh water, as a drinking water.
Yes.
Perfect. So salinities play an important role in the growth of culture organism through osmoregulation of body minerals from that of the surrounding water. Salinity range from 1 to 45 ppt as per the culture species. So our vanami, yes, we can do the culture from 0 to 45 ppt. If our salinity will be low, so our survival, our growth will be impacted, but we can manage with the help of different minerals because they have some requirement in terms of the minerals like sodium, potassium, magnesium and calcium. So we have a some substitute like in terms of the dolomite, it have a calcium and magnesium substitute, and for the potassium and sodium we also have some alternate. So we can weekly or bi-weekly we can add in our water so that at the time of molting, at the time of growth, they need the balanced diet for the proper growth.
Prashant, let me just clarify. You said that the lower the salinity, the faster the growth is?
No. Lower the salinity, you will get a low survival and low growth if you not provide the sufficient minerals for the survival.
Okay, how about if the salinity is low, but I give the enough minerals?
Right. So, if we will provide the enough mineral to our aquatic animals, so we will increase our survival also and increase the growth also. Because our motto is we will complete that culture within 90 to 120 days and our size, harvested size, around 22 to 30 grams.
Okay.
So salinity plays an important role for the survival and growth, but we can manage with the help of balance of the minerals. So we will add on the time by time, analyze our water parameter according to requirement, we will manipulate this ratio. I will also cover that topic. Shall we proceed?
Yes, please.
Next one is dissolve oxygen. Whenever you will consider as a aquaculture, so just work on the dissolve oxygen part, because if you provide the sufficient dissolve oxygen is your environment, you will increase the success rate around 50 to 60%, because your vanami is a very tangible item. They need sufficient water quality and they want clear environment for the proper growth and proper survival. So atmospheric oxygen cross the air water boundary and dissolve in the water matrix. The only way that oxygen can introduce from air to water is by diffusion. Dissolved oxygen is measured either in mg per liter or part per million, ppm, with 0 ppm representing total oxygen depletion and 15 ppm representing the maximum or saturation concentration. There is about 21% oxygen content in the air. Air acts as a big reservoir for oxygen concentration in water is limited by its solubility. So dissolved oxygen, it is a part where our oxygen has been dissolved in the water, but we cannot simply dissolve that oxygen in the water. We have some limitation for the water. Minimum value is the 0 ppm and higher value is 12 to 15 ppm. So once we will build our setup, so we will plan accordingly as per our species, as per our stocking density, as per our culture practice. So 3 to 4 ppm milligram per liter is the minimum and ideal range of the res setup. If you are doing the culture in the bioflock, so around 6 to 6.5 milligram per liter is the ideal range.
Prashant, I have a couple of questions.
Yeah, please.
Let me just clarify. You mentioned that 100% saturation of oxygen is 15 ppm. Am I right?
Right.
So when I say 50% saturation, that means 7.5 ppm?
Right.
Okay. And then just to clarify, you said that the ideal dissolved oxygen for Vaname is 3 to 4 ppm?
Right.
Does that mean that I should not go higher than 4? Because from what I've read, the higher the dissolved oxygen, the better it is for the shrimp.
Right. Because all the parameters depends on our stocking density.
Okay.
Because once we will do the overstocking, so more carbon dioxide will be released in your water. So we need a more dissolved oxygen so that our carbon dioxide will release easily from the water surface. Otherwise, we need to install one more machine in our res setup, is a carbon dioxide and gas reducer. It is reduce all the gases from the water column. So okay. Once we will consider and we will discuss our res setup, so we will correlate all the vector parameter from this session to the next session. So right now I am trying to provide all the basic information so that you can easily correlate which machine and what is the importance is the res farming. Perfect.
Yep.
Next is the pH. So pH is the most important water parameter in our aquaculture, because your survival and your ammonia concentration, your nitrite concentration, nitrate concentration, your aquatic animal growth completely depend on the pH, and pH depends on the alkalinity. pH or the concentration of the hydrogen ions. Hydrogen ions means our water is made from H2O. H2O is the hydrogen ion and O is the oxygen ion. Present in the pond water is a measure of acidity or alkalinity. The pH scale extend from 0 to 14 with 0 most acidic and 14 is the most alkaline. So our ideal range is 7. But for the Vaname and for the aquatic animals, our suggested range is 7.5 to 8.5. Greater than pH 9 is dangerous as ammonia toxicity increase rapidly. So your ammonia will be high. At high temperature, fish are more sensitive to pH change. So just focus to provide the sufficient and ideal water parameter. So for the pH, 7.5 to 8.5 is the ideal range. If you are doing the res, so this is a one more component installed in your setup, is a pH regulator, which is regulate the continuous monitoring of the pH and manage the optimum range. The pH should be monitored before dawn of the, so we have a some timing for the water monitoring. Early 5 to 6 a.m. and afternoon time it's the 2 to 3 p.m. We have a two window where we will examine the time in our culture, because shrimp will not give the leverage to manage the water. If you are doing the culture of the carp or you are doing the culture of the catfish, yes, you have a sufficient time to manage the water parameter. But shrimp need a continuous intervention from your end for the in term of the monitoring, in term of the idle range. 24/7 monitoring is required from your end for your farm sustainability and 100% success rate. And alkalinity above 20 ppm, calcium carbonate is preferred in the pond. So whenever you will check the alkalinity, because you are doing the culture in the fresh water, so alkalinity will be down, but below 20 ppm will not go that. Otherwise, we will add the dolomite and calcium carbonate to maintain the sufficient range of the alkalinity. More fluctuation is not recommended in the aquaculture. Around 0.2 to 0.5 point saturation is suggested, but beyond that, it is not recommended. After trying to control your water parameter in the ideal range. I am clear?
Yep.
Okay. So shall we proceed?
Just one clarification.
Yeah, please.
The best time to measure pH would be 6 a.m. and around 2 to 3 p.m. Am I right?
Right.
Okay. Just wanted to clarify.
Because in the morning time, you will get the range of the lower pH, and in the afternoon, you will get the range of the higher pH, so that we can segregate and take the decision accordingly. On the single value and on the single figure, we will not do it any operation in the hurry.
Understood.
Next is ammonia. Yes, you are doing the culture in the res. So yes, we will have a one filtration. It's a biological filter. So it will consume all the nitrogen from the environment, and it will provide the good water source for your culture species. Ammonia is the second gas of importance in the fish culture. It is significant to good fish production is overwhelming. High ammonia level can arise from overfeeding, rich protein diet, excess feed decay to build the toxic ammonia gases. So ammonia basically jo build hai hamara, providing the excess feed once we are doing the overstocking. So our daily feed ratio will be increased. So our overfeeding will be increased. So our excess ammonia will be built in our water column. So once ammonia will be high, so we need a good biological filter installed in our environment so that it can easily manipulate and reduce the effect of the ammonia. Because ammonia, it's a total ammonia nitrogen, and it is having NH3 and NH4. NH3 is stands for ammonia, and NH4 is stands for ammonia. Ammonia is a more toxic. So once our biological filter come in the functioning, so it will convert ammonia to nitrite. Nitrate is also harmful to our aquatic animals. Then it will convert nitrite to nitrate. It is working as a nitrification cycle, and it will take around 2 to 3 weeks to settle out this nitrification cycle. In the coming session, I also cover this important topic. Right now, I am trying to figure out all the required parameters. And ammonia is completely depend on the pH and temperature. If temperature will be high, your ammonia formation will be high. If your pH and temperature is in the ideal range, ammonia will not give any effect to your aquatic animals. I am clear, or do you have some doubts?
Just a to clarify. So again, the higher the temperature, the higher the ammonia.
Right.
And the higher the pH, the higher the ammonia as well.
Right.
Okay.
Because in the coming session, I also cover some nitrification process so that you can get the clear understanding. How is water chemistry work in the back end? Once you will understand the water chemistry, you can do the culture in any technology. In the simple glass bowl, you can do the culture. Without any filtration, without any oxygen, yes, you can simply do that culture. Yes, but we are doing the commercial level farming. So yes, our time duration is the most important part, because we are daily using the commercial feed, daily we are using the commercial electricity, all the labor expenses going on. So yes, our culture should be completed in the defined period. So we will plan accordingly so that we not lose our hardcore money. Is it clear?
Yes.
So next is the hardness. One is salinity, another one is hardness. Mineral substances are dissolved in water. Among these, the metal calcium and magnesium, along with their counter ion carbonate, comprise the basis for the measurement of the hardness. Optimum hardness of the aquaculture is the range of 40 to 400 ppm of hardness. Hard water have the capability of buffering the effect of heavy metals such as copper, zinc, or general toxic to the fish. The hardness is a vital factor in maintaining the good pond equilibrium. In the previous slide, once we are discussing for the salinity, we have discussed for the sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium. These are the four basic minerals requirement for the vanami and for the any aquatic animals. So you are doing the culture in the fresh water, so our fresh water range of the hardness is 40 to 400 ppm. If you are trying to get the information of your drinking water, so our drinking water should be range around 250 to 350 ppm, and they have all the balanced mineral in term of the sodium, in term of the calcium, in term of the magnesium, in term of the potassium, and lots of other material also available in the suggested range. So yes, you are doing the culture in the fresh water. So once you will procure some toolkit like TDS meter, salinity meter, you can easily examine the current values of your water source, so that we can take the decision which minerals in which amount we required in that water body. I am clear?
Yep, I just have a question again.
Yeah, please.
So you mentioned that tap water already has around 250 ppm of hardness, right?
Right.
How about deep well water?
Deep well water around 450 to 550 ppm.
All right.
And last value of the fresh water around 800 to 900 ppm. After that, this water treated as a brackish water or saline water. It is not suitable for the drinking purpose, but you can do the culture of your aquatic species for the saline water. Point is clear?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. Second is turbidity. Water turbidity refers to the quantity of suspended materials. Once we are providing lots of organic matter in terms of the feed, in terms of the minerals, in terms of the molasses, lots of matters we are directly introduced in the water. So our turbidity will be increased. But in the rest, we have some mechanism in term of the protein skimmer, in term of the drum filter, in term of the mechanical filter. So our suspended particles will be segregated from the water bodies, and our water column very visible from the naked eyes. Easily we can see the water column and our aquatic animals in our tank. So turbidity will not much affect in the res culture. PSB is a photosynthetic bacteria because we are doing the culture in the indoor. So this bacteria will not work. We are trying to work with the help of nitrifying bacteria, Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter, which will convert our ammonia to nitrogen. And it will release with the help of the oxygen in our environment. Our environment have 71% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and 1% is another gases in term of the carbon dioxide, in term of the carbon monoxide, in term of the ozone gases, and another gases. Is it clear?
Yep.
Next one is water quality management. The population of phytoplankton and microorganisms. So we are doing the culture of indoor. So in our environment, we are not doing the culture of the phytoplankton because phytoplankton want the direct sunlight in our environment. So we have cut that information and we are providing the dissolved oxygen artificially in the environment to maintain our good ecosystem. The diet fluctuation of dissolved oxygen, pH and carbon dioxide severe as an indicator of their population. So our DO, our pH and carbon dioxide is directly proportionate to your stocking density. If you want to high stocking culture, high density culture, so just plan it very carefully to maintain and your build the res setup. Maybe adequate. Also carbon dioxide is more difficult to measure. 20 milligram per liter is the suggested value for the carbon dioxide, but in the Vanami culture it is very harmful because we are doing the culture in the high stocking density. So whenever we will stock in the higher density, so they will produce more carbon dioxide. So for the faster release, we have a proper system so that we did not face any huge mortality in our environment. Daily measurement are conducted at early hours is 5 to 6 a.m. and afternoon measurement is 2 to 3 p.m. and after 5 to 6 hours, one more measurement is required for the successful Vanami culture. Because Vanami culture is a 24/7 culture. Perfect.
I have a question again, Prashant.
Yeah, please.
What's the ideal carbon dioxide level for Vanami again?
Lower value, 20 milligram per liter. 12 to 15 is the ideal, but less than 20 milligram per liter is the suggested value.
Okay, but technically lower than 12 is better.
Yes.
Okay.
Most of the water quality problems can be solved with adequate water exchange. Once your system has been failed and you are not able to provide the sufficient water quality to your aquatic animals and you are a condition of do and die, so you can do the immediate water exchange because your success is most important for us for the success of the system. Because RES is a proven technology, but we are here for the farmer and for youth and for our entrepreneur success. Once your system has been failed and you are not able to manage the water parameter, so simply 10%, 20%, 25% or 40% water exchange will resolve all the issues. But in the rest, yes, we will use the same water on the daily basis. On the daily basis, only 10% fresh water has been added in that culture for this success. Because fresh water is not the success of your culture. A stable water, optimum water parameter is the success of your culture. I am clear?
Yep.
Perfect. So, we are here to promote not much water exchange. Do it in your culture. If you are doing the culture in the pond farming, in the cemented pond, in the earthen pond, in the biofloc, in the rest. So we are not suggest more water exchange because it will worse the condition, not solve the issues. Water exchange is the first method to improve pond management except when good quality of water is not available. A drastic change to the pond environment should be avoided. So in the previous slide, I also provide one hint, 0.2 to 0.5 point variation in every parameter is recommended, but beyond that, it will directly affect to the your aquatic animals. Culture organism has been greatly weakened as a result of nutrition depletion and disease. So every time you should work on the, once you will work on the water quality, next focus is your proper feed, balanced feed. Your banami requirement in term of the protein, 30 to 35% protein is entire culture. From 3 to 4 months, they want that much protein from your end in term of the all the mineral balance. Ponds are being treated with chemicals and medicine. Before starting your culture, just treat your ponds, your tanks before they are manufactured by n number of materials. So before stocking your seed, before doing the water preparation, just sanitize entire environment. After that, you will go for the water preparation. While doing water exchange, several parameters should be noticed, such as pH value, salinity, temperature, turbidity, and other parameters related to defining good pond environment. So every time you have all the information on your tip, which parameter affect how much and which parameter is related to which next parameter. Like pH and temperature is directly related to ammonia. So we can easily correlate all the parameter equations. Next one is aeration. In all the terminology, yes, aeration is the very important part because in the aquaculture, only 2 to 3 major concern area is there. One is aeration, second is circulation, and third is filtration. If three parameter and three values are okay in your design, so your design will be perfect and you will not face any issue at the time of harvesting. So aeration, what is the role of aeration? It increases the dissolved oxygen level of the water and prevents oxygen depletion during the night. Every time you face the issue at the night time, it accelerates the diffusion effect of not only the oxygen but also enable the capture of release of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is important for culture of algae and therefore maintenance of appropriate water color. So we are doing the indoor culture, so algae will not form because we are not having any indoor sunlight. So we are maintaining the proper water quality and release of the carbon dioxide. It facilitates the violation of the undesirable gases such as nitrogen, ammonia, CH4 and hydrogen sulfide. So whenever those are the harmful gases, they are easily released from the water column so that our aquatic animal have the ideal and optimum water range. It reduces the daily fluctuation range of the pH value. It also supports the value of the pH. It controls the value of pH, dissolved oxygen, salinity and temperature in the pond water. So if you provide the proper aeration, so around 50 to 70% problem has been reduced. Only 20 to 30% day-to-day management is required for your successful operation. I am clear?
Yep.
As the pond water moves in a circular fashion, the pond bottom is cleaned and the waste matter gets accumulated in the center and the corners. By this method, most of the pond bottom is kept clean. So you are doing the culture in the res. So once you will do the flush your water, so it is directly come in the drum filter, or you can say it's a mechanical filter where it is segregate all the heavy particles, then it will send that water to your biological filter. In the coming session, I will discuss all that things. In that session, we will cover all the water parameter. Removal of dissolved metabolic organics. One of the important stress factor is the increase of dissolved metabolic organics in culture water. It can increase ammonia and microorganism. The best way to facilitate the removal of metabolic waste in a pond is by flushing out water from the bottom. Constantly maintaining high DO in the pond through supplemental aeration and water exchange enhance nitrification. Nitrification is a major mechanism for ammonia removal in well-aerated pond. Aerators are usually operated during dark 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. when oxygen depletion is likely to occur, and at noon, 12 noon to 2 p.m. when temperature and oxygen stratification can become significant. So these are some mechanism to success for your culture. So you are doing the high stocking density culture, so 24 into 7 oxygen is required for the successful culture. We cannot close our aerator for 12 hours. No, if we are doing the culture in the extensive farming or normal intensive culture, we can do that practice, but we are crossing and book more profit in term of the res. So definitely it is a 24 into 7 operation. We need all the machine, all the operation, all the pumps running 24 into 7 without fail. It is clear?
Yep.
Maintaining water quality and preventing disease. So you already work on the res, so definitely it will control your water quality. And preventing disease, it is a one more filter installed in your environment. It is a UV filter. It will kill all the bacteria, all the viruses, all the harmful disease from your water. So this is a simple thumb rule. Don't overstock. If you want the ideal water quality, so don't go for the overstock. You are doing the res. So yes, res have all the capability. So yes, we can do the overstocking. Temperature fluctuation of water, especially during water change. So most of the time water fluctuation will harm for the on your aquatic animals. So we have all the mechanism, but in your Philippines we don't have much saturation in term of the temperature. You have an ideal range from 20 to 32 degree centigrade, not beyond, not down. I am right?
That's right.
Yeah, so you can also skip that point. Increase of free carbon dioxide, unionized ammonia and organics due to decaying, excess feed and dead animals. So you already work on that, because you once you will flush water from your pond, because it will first go to the mechanical filter. It will protect all the heavy metals, all the dead organism, all the organic load, and then circulate the remaining water to your biological filter. So you are 100% sure your aquatic animal will get a good treated water for the proper growth, for proper survival. Poor nutrition, improperly fed fish and prawn. Sometimes farmers want to cut the operational cost and they will prefer the low percentage protein feed, but it will increase the culture time and also the nutrition deficiency in your shrimp, and also you can get the mass mortality in your culture. So don't do the poor nutrition in term of the minerals, in term of the protein requirement. Minimum protein requirement of the vanami shrimp is 30 to 35% protein. And it is a omnivorous, so it will prefer the non-veg feed for the good survival, for the good growth. So we will work accordingly in the coming session. We will also take that session also. The high level of toxic pollutant in water that may contain heavy metals such as copper, silica, lead, nickel, mercury, fluoride, lots of other chemicals. So we already cover all the filtration part. Once you will get the knowledge, what is the importance of all the filtration mechanism. And once we will get the clear clarity of your budget, we will suggest accordingly which filter is more required for your successful culture. Because without drum filter, our RAS system is no use. Without biological filter, our RAS system is not used. So in the 9 machine, we have some essential component. We definitely procure it. So in the initial screen, that's why I have said you will prefer the complete RAS or semi RAS, so that we can try to reduce your input cost, because we want to book your profit as soon as possible. Otherwise we will hard to achieve our break even point. I think in the second to third culture, we will achieve our break-even point. I am clear?
Yep.
So I have maintained one tables for your reference. First is the temperature. Optimum temperature range is 22 to 32 degrees centigrade. You have a digital thermometer. With the help of, you can measure your atmospheric temperature, also your water temperature. Second one is salinity, because you are doing the culture in the fresh water, so salinity not beyond that 0.2, 0.5 or 0.8. so you can examine from the refractometer, and also we have some test kit for that. Next is pH. Our ideal range is 7.5 to 8.5. You have some litmus paper for the pH test. Also, you have a API test kit for that. Also, you have a digital pH meter to examine that value. I also share the link so that you can also procure that list. Second one is dissolved oxygen is the main requirement for the ecosystem. You have a two measurement equipment for that. One is a DO meter, it is a digital, and second one is a DO kit. From the chemical, you can also measure the DO. Around 15 to 20 minutes it will take, but cost will be less. DO meter, it is a digital, so cost will be high. BOD and COD we will cover in the coming slide. It is directly related to DO. If you will provide the proper DO, so it will easily manage. So this is the ideal range. So for the total ammonia nitrogen, less than 1 ppm. And for the nitrite and nitrate, it is less than 0.25 for the Vanami culture, because Vanami is very sophisticated. They need a proper and ideal temperature and ideal water parameter. So definitely we will work hard, and accordingly we will plan our system for the 100% success rate. This is our small team, and this is our WhatsApp and Telegram number where we already connected. If you have any doubt, any question, yes, you can raise. And after that session, I also provide that recording for your further reference. If we have escaped or we have miscommunicated some information, so you can also correct them. We will try to correct them. And definitely we will work hard, and shortly we will provide the detail for the our coming session, where we will cover our RAS planning and guideline, our aquatic animal in term of the shrimp, habit and habitat, and feeding parts. So do you have any preference? Tomorrow or day after tomorrow, at the same time we can take the session, or any specific?
For tomorrow, let me check my schedule.
Perfect.
I'm otherwise available tomorrow same time, 6:30 as well.
Okay.
Do you have students after this session?
Yeah.
Okay.
So because next session I want to try to make it 2 to 3 hours, so that we can cover most of the parts for our study materials, so that we can plan accordingly further.
Okay, I actually prefer that, if we could do longer sessions so that we could finish earlier.
Right, because this is our first session. First, we are trying to basic building block. I already provide all the water chemistry, so you can digest all the water parameter and note down all the information, always have on your tip. So in the next session, we will correlate all the terms, all the water parameter, so that you can get the clear understanding how to effectively build our RAS. Because you also have seen lots of video on the YouTube, but we will examine from scratch and for the commercial level. We are not doing the farming on the backyard pond type. We are doing the farming on the commercial level. So our system will work on the commercial level. Any person can see that pond. Yes, it is quite impressive and have all the equipment and infra to maintain good water quality.
Understood. So tomorrow our session will be from 6:30 p.m. until what time?
Right. I will share the session detail and also the detailed topics for the tomorrow session.
Are we going to use the same link?
Yeah, we can.
Okay, so it's going to be 6:30 until what time? How many hours?
We will cover 2 to 3 hours.
Okay, so from 6:30 to around 8:30.
Right.